Darden Church, it is so good to connect with you again for our 9th episode of Taking God at His Word, where we're helping you and by empowering you to be able to disciple the people you love in your life. And what we're going to do this week is we're going to kind of switch it up a little bit, because one of the things we want to do here at this church is we really want to align what we're teaching and what we're instructing our people to do to help them grow as disciples. So here's what we're going to do. We're getting ready to kick off an awesome series that I cannot wait to hear, as Reverend Casberg is going to start off this week with a new series called The Names of God, where we're going to learn about the various names of God and how those names reveal to us who He is and reveals to us a lot about His character and how His character impacts our lives. And so what I wanted to do for this episode, we're going to keep it real short and sweet, but this is, I want to engage you all in this. I want you to really think about this. We need to ask ourselves the question, what's in a name? Do names matter? Now, for us nowadays in the 21st century, I don't think we really consider much about what's in a name, right? Like, we don't think about it. We usually just go with popular names that sound good. But here's the thing. In ancient Hebrew culture, when they named someone, that name revealed something about the person who was named. It revealed something about their character. And as we're going to see in this series, as Reverend Casberg leads us and he preaches and teaches to us, what we're going to see is that through the names of God, God is revealing, He's self-revealing, right? He's revealing to us who He is and what He's come to do. He's revealing to us that He is there and that He is with us and that He is moving on behalf of His people. And we're going to learn so much about His character through this series. Now, to kick it off, right, to think about this series, I wanted to jump to the book of Exodus. I know we've walked through the book of John, but like I said, we're not really walking through a book. What we're trying to do is think about concepts and ideas of how to look at Scripture and how to apply it to our lives. And, you know, I came across Exodus chapter 3, verses 13 through 14. And this is Moses. Moses is being called by God to go lead the people of Israel out of Egypt and to lead the Israelites out. And this is what it says in verse 13. It says, "Then Moses said to God, 'If I come to the people of Israel and say to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you, and they ask me, what is his name? What shall I say to them?' And God said to Moses, 'I am who I am.' And also said to Moses, 'Say this to the people of Israel, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and thus I'm to be remembered throughout all generations.'" Man, there is so much said right there in that. And we could sit here and just, I mean, there's been theological volumes written on this phrase, "I am who I am." But here, I think, is the big takeaway for us. What God is revealing to Moses here and what he's revealing to us is that when he says, "I am who I am," he's telling us more than he just exists. He's saying, listen, all these other false gods and idols that these people worship, they're not really alive, but I am. I am the one who's made all this. I am the sovereign king of the universe. I am the one who exists, and I am the one who walks with you and sees you. Because he even says to him, tell him I'm the God of your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That means our God is a living God. He's not a mute idol who can't speak or act on our behalf. But brother, God is right there with us in the thick of it. So this is what I want us to do this week. Around the dinner table, whether you're a parent, wherever you are, whether you're one of our families or if you're by yourself, what I want you to do is I really want you to think about this question. What is in a name? Why do names matter? Like, for instance, for me, my name is Patrick. I go by my middle name, Patrick. And Patrick is like a Gaelic name that means nobleman, right? Or noble father. And so, but I think when my family named me, I wasn't named because I'm a nobleman or a noble father. Part of the reason I was named Patrick is I looked in the research in 1984, Patrick was a very popular name for babies that year. In fact, it was one of the top names for babies that year, and I was named that. And I also had people in my family by the name of Pat. My mom's name's Patricia as well, too. So we need to think about what's in a name. When God says, "I am who I am," he is revealing something to us about his character, that he is the living God. So I want you to sit around the dinner table tonight with your family and ask yourself the question, what does my name mean and why does it matter? And then ask yourself the question, why does it matter about the names of God and how do those names impact my life? As we're going to see in our first sermon coming up here from Andrew, as he talks about Elohim, God the Creator, we need to ask ourselves the question, How has God moved in our lives? How has he created and done things in our life? And how does his name reveal to us how he continues to recreate us and continue to work in our lives? Take those questions, pray on them, write them out, share them with your family, ask your children, ask your friends, ask your spouse, and just watch where the conversation goes, because what we're going to see in this series is that God's going to reveal to us so much about his character, and it's going to be transformative in our lives because his character is what we're being remade into by and through his son, Jesus Christ. God bless.